Welcome to this getting started tutorial about the Blazor MultiSelect Dropdown from Syncfusion. Imagine that you want to choose your favorite sports names from a collection. Surely you would like to select multiple names from that list. In this case, the Blazor MultiSelect Dropdown from Syncfusion would fit perfectly. It allows you to choose multiple items from a huge collection and also displays the selected items on the UI. First, I will start with the Blazor application creation process. For this, I need to make sure .NET Core SDK latest version is installed in my machine. I should also have Visual Studio Code or Visual Studio 2019 installed to create a Blazor application. In this tutorial, I am going to create a new Blazor WebAssembly app. So, let me open Visual Studio 2019 and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose Blazor app and click Next. Then, I name my project Blazor Samples and click the Next button. Here, I will click Create button with default target framework to complete the project creation. The project has been created and is ready to use. If you want to know more about Blazor WebAssembly apps and how to add Syncfusion components, then you can click on the video link shown in the above YouTube card. Now, let's add the Blazor MultiSelect Dropdown component. First, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor Dropdown's NuGet package in my application. I open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project and choosing Manage NuGet Packages. Then, I search for Syncfusion Blazor Dropdowns in the Browse tab and install it in my project. Once the installation is completed, I navigate to the imports.razor file, and here, I add the Syncfusion Blazor Dropdowns namespace. Now I can start using the Blazor MultiSelect Dropdown component in any of the components available in the Pages folder. Next, I open the program.cs file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Blazor service by calling the method addSyncfusionBlazor within this main method. Also, I should register the valid license key in my application. So, let me register the trial license key by using the registerLicense method. Then, I need to define the CSS for the Blazor MultiSelect dropdown. I navigate to the index.html file to reference the CSS file from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. Okay, the configuration steps are done. Now, let me proceed to add the Blazor MultiSelect dropdown. So, open the index.razor page and here, I will include the SF MultiSelect component by replacing the default code. To populate the data source, first, I need to create a code block. Here, I have planned to display sports name in the MultiSelect dropdown. So, within this code block, I will define a model class games data model with two fields, name and ID. Then, I will create a list games data of type games data model and assign an array of objects with data source fields. Now, I will define the t-item and t-value properties with appropriate values to specify the data source type and MultiSelect dropdown value field type respectively. Next, I need to assign this list games data to the data source property of the MultiSelect dropdown. For this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the field property of the MultiSelect dropdown component. So here, I will define a MultiSelect field settings tag and map the fields name to the text property, and ID to the value property. Here, this data source contains a list of sports, so let me define the property placeholder with the value select a game, which will be displayed in the MultiSelect dropdown component as its description. Now, I will press F5 to run the application. When you look at the Blazor MultiSelect dropdown, you can see the sports name listed here. You can also notice that the MultiSelect dropdown displays the short description select a game. Here, by default, the pop-up width will automatically adjust according to the MultiSelect dropdown input element's width and the default height will be 350 pixel. So, if you would like to set a custom height and width to the pop-up, then you need to use the properties pop-up width and pop-up height and assign them custom values within this MultiSelect dropdown code. Look at the MultiSelect dropdown component now, where the pop-up is displayed with a custom height and width. Suppose I want to bind a remote data source to a Blazor MultiSelect dropdown. The Syncfusion Blazor MultiSelect Dropdown comes with different options like a web API adapter, custom adapter, and offline mode. From these options, I will choose web API adapter for now, as I am going to bind a web API remote URL to the MultiSelect Dropdown component. To bind a remote data source, I want to add the data manager control here to act as a gateway between the MultiSelect Dropdown and the data source. The data manager uses queries to interact with both local and remote data sources. So, for first step, I will import the namespace Syncfusion Blazor data within the imports.razor file. Then, I need to define data manager component with the properties URL, adapter, and cross-domain inside the MultiSelect Dropdown code. In the URL, I will be using the already available remote URL service, which will retrieve the list of data through a post action and then bind the resultant data to the MultiSelect Dropdown. Also, I have set the Web API adapter here, as the URL is assigned with an existing Web API service. The cross-domain option is set to true to allow cross-origin domain requests. Here, this remote URL contains four fields, namely employee ID, first name, designation, and country. So, to access those fields, within this code block, I will create a model class employee data model with four fields, first name, employee ID, designation, and country. Also, I need to map the remote data source fields, so let me map the fields, first name and employee ID, to the text and value properties respectively. Since I have set employee names as data sources, let me change the placeholder property value to select a name. Now, I am going to remove the data source property from the MultiSelect dropdown code because I have defined the SF data manager component here, which acts as the data source for the MultiSelect dropdown component. Along with this, I need to change the TItem value as employee data model to specify the data source type. You can see the MultiSelect dropdown, which shows employee names over here. Let me summarize some of the important points. We have seen how to add the Blazor MultiSelect dropdown from Syncfusion to a Blazor WebAssembly app. Also, we have seen how to populate list data and remote data sources in the MultiSelect dropdown, and how to set the custom height and width for the MultiSelect dropdown pop-up. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.